If you've never written a scientific paper, you may be uncertain about how to structure it and exactly what to include in each section. In this video, I'll review the parts of a scientific paper and describe what goes into each one. Most journals follow a typical format of title page, abstract, introduction, methods, results, discussion, conclusions, acknowledgements, and references. A few may place the methods at the end of the narrative. Some may combine results and discussion. You should follow your target journal's author instructions as to the required order. Let's first look at the title. The title of your paper should be carefully crafted to set your paper apart. It should accurately describe what the paper is about. Try to minimize technical jargon and avoid extraneous words such as a study of. The abstract should entice the reader to download and read your paper. Concisely state the main objectives or problem first. Briefly describe the location of the study, if relevant, and the methods. Then summarize your key findings. Finally, state the main conclusions and significance of the work. Make the reader want to read the paper. Key words, along with the title, determine how often your paper will be located and cited by others. Select key words carefully and include words likely to be search terms not used in the title. Next is the introduction, which sets the stage for the study. In it, you define the nature and scope of the topic under study. Ensure that the introduction has the three basic parts: the literature review, the benefit to the reader, and the overall approach taken. Review the pertinent literature, providing a solid background for your study. Clearly explain how your work will benefit the reader by solving a problem, resolving a conflict in the literature, or reporting a new method. Finally, state the general approach you will take to address your goal by listing objectives and questions you will answer. Generate a sense of curiosity in the reader. Make them want to continue reading. Next is the method section, where you describe exactly how you carried out the study. Describe the study area and the methods clearly and in sufficient detail so that someone else can repeat the study. Report any tests or procedures you undertook to avoid bias or minimize variance. Provide details for any unusual or new technique. Include information about experimental design, statistical models, and tests. Next is the results section. Be selective and include only those results that show something relative to your main questions or hypotheses. Put the rest in supplementary materials. Be systematic and organize the results by topic or experiment. Start with your most important data, not problems encountered during the study. Let the figures and tables do the talking. In the text, summarize the main patterns in the data and provide information not readily apparent in the tables and figures. Don't hide your results behind statistical jargon. Instead, describe what happened and use statistics to support your statements. In the discussion, explain your results, don't repeat them. Put your work into perspective by comparing it to other work. Keep speculation to a minimum, but do use a logical deductive approach to point out reasonable explanations for your findings. Discuss agreement or disagreement with previous work without making disparaging comments about other researchers' work. Discuss theoretical or practical applications. Use personal pronouns sparingly and mainly when stating an opinion or making a judgment. For example, we hypothesize that the mechanism underlying this relationship is. Write concluding remarks, not a rehash of the discussion or a summary. Why is this work important and what are the broader implications? Leave the reader with a satisfied feeling, not what was the point of this paper. In the acknowledgements section, you describe who contributed to the work in addition to the listed authors and sources of funding and other help. The reference section lists the sources you cited in the narrative. Carefully follow the journal's formatting instructions for the literature cited. Well, that's a brief summary of how a scientific paper is structured and what goes into each section. For greater detail about how to write each section, see the links in the description below. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to hit the like button if you found this information helpful.